One of the things that I have been very interested in is the effect of pesticides on reptiles. Part of the reason that I chose reptiles is they're quite understudied. There's a lot of them, and they are often in aquatic environments. And
they're the coolest thing ever.
That's right. Absolutely. They're pretty cool. So the animal that I'm working with is the northern water snake, and people will be able to see those pretty much anywhere. We gather them from Lake Charleston and Lake Mattoon. They feed mostly on fish and amphibians, so they're really exposed to a lot of pesticide runoff, which is pretty common in this area. Mm-hmm. So what I was most interested in is how the pesticides affect the babies that the water snakes have.
I know this is not related to your research specifically, Lori, but how did we come by this animal? Why is this animal so special?
Well, these water snakes are not very liked by a lot of people. And so that's another reason that I'm very interested in working with them, because I think that it's really important to educate people about how important they are to the ecosystem and to humans. Another aspect of what I've been doing is a lot of education with students. I've given lots of presentations to elementary students and to high school students. So that's a really important aspect of this lab, and also with my own personal research.
I think that's very commendable, because snakes in particular, these organisms are so often maligned and persecuted by the public without really an understanding, without a firm understanding for their biology and really some of the remarkable things that they're capable of doing in the wild, in the natural setting.
A little bit of background on the study is we caught about 25 females, and they were all pregnant. And throughout the entire summer, we had a whole team of students that helped me, Team Neurodia. We had a whole team of students that helped me, and every week we weighed the moms and we fed them fish that had been injected with a pesticide called atrazine. And what we found are some pretty interesting things. We're still analyzing the results, but we wanted to measure the estradiol levels, which are a really important female hormone. They form things like estrogen. And so we took blood samples and we saw how it affects the babies. So all those blood samples are being analyzed right now using some special equipment and some special assays. And we're gonna find where the estradiol levels, where these estrogen levels were for the different animals, and how they fluctuate throughout the pregnancy and how they change according to their exposure to this chemical. Since people have been making things like pesticides, there have been over 20,000 new chemicals, and only about 20 of them have been studied extensively. So we really don't know how they affect the environment and how they affect us. So using these guys to understand that, help us understand that, is something that I believe is really important. And I've had the opportunity to do that in Steve's lab and here at Eastern. And that's been something that has been something I'm really grateful for. And it's been a really great experience.